Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Let's discuss computer science. Today I'll be explaining some of the tips and tricks for attempting the national eligibility test, that is NET examination, as we have very less time, less than 2 months of time we have for NET exam. So let us see some tips and tricks. Every year the number of people who is attending NET examination is gradually increasing. So it's going to be a very important examination at the national level compared to GATE. Even the number of people attending this exam also increasing like anything. Why? Because from 2021, people wants to continue in teaching field. They should hold a PhD degree as per the GO, recent GO. And for PhD entrance examination, NET is a must. And nowadays for most of the government jobs also, they are computer science related jobs, they are asking for GATE, NET or SET exam cards. So it's a very important examination. So coming to this, it's a general video. The ground rules before going to the video, thing is that this is not for serious aspirants. And why I'm saying serious aspirants, people they could have failed in the last attempt, but they'll think like okay, let us tag this for the next time. So they will start the preparation. Okay, so after 10 days or 15 days they will leave it, and again they will open the books just 1 month before or 10 days before the examination. So those are not serious about the preparation. So this is not for the serious aspirants. Why? Because here I'll be completely explaining the shortcuts, how to crack it. So these ideas works out for me, that's why I'm just sharing those things. So this is not for the people who are full-time preparing for NET. This is because some people have no time for preparation, because they would be in different fields like software field or else teaching field or else doing some private jobs, bank field. So they have, even though they have interest in writing this exam, but because of time constraint, they would have not get time for preparation. So here this video belongs to that category, those who doesn't have time for preparation. So and the third thing is, I'll be purely, it's a shortcut or blind marks. So serious aspirants, don't go through this video. Okay, I'll be, this is for the above two categories only. Okay, because according to me, we should not search shortcut for life or achieving anything. So even though it's not a good thing, but still for a few categories I'm preparing this video. So these are the ground rules. If you go through this pattern, we have two papers, paper 1 and paper 2. Paper 1 is a general paper. It contains teaching aptitude, research aptitude and some of the other contents, reasoning, data comprehension, computer terminology or general knowledge questions. Okay, paper 2 is a pure subject paper. So it's very important to have good score in paper 1 also. Without paper 1, you cannot qualify for NET examination. It's very important. So for that, basic things required are time management. You should be very careful about it. You should practice well, then only you will be very good in time management. Okay, and there should be some common sense. Okay, you should not blindly go for a particular question and tick for option 2, option B, option C, option A. So don't go blindly, you should have some common sense. Okay, then only you will get at least some questions get corrected. Next one is, you should have some basic mathematical skills. Okay, without mathematical skills, basic mathematical skills, it's very difficult to have some good score in paper 1, because most of the things are, there are many questions are dependent on mathematical formulas in paper 1. So if you come to the paper 1, the thing is that as per my knowledge, don't go through the complete theory. Okay, see, most of the people not aware of teaching aptitude and research aptitude before this, before preferring for this NET examination. Why? Because they could have not have this in syllabus. in their PG or UG. So don't go through the complete syllabus, because those are all, I mean, out of 100% of teaching and research aptitude questions, 50% are subject related and other 50% will test your common sense. Okay, if you are a student, how you will behave? If you are a teacher, how you will treat? Okay, there should be some common sense. Without that, you cannot answer that. So even if you prepare for completely, if you are having sound knowledge in teaching research aptitude, you will score 8 out of 10. But if you use common sense, if you have some good knowledge, if you go through the questions clear properly, you can answer at least 5 questions out of 10. So there will be a marginal difference. So don't go through the books for theory, teaching aptitude and research aptitude theory. So just go through some important topics if you have time. Okay, otherwise, first of all, concentrate on these below topics. Concentrate on data interpretation. See, there should be, it's a definite marks, because if you have basic mathematical skills, you will definitely score 5 out of 5 here. You will get 5 questions from data interpretation. Data comprehension, you will get 5 questions. Logical reasoning, 5 questions. Computer terminology, 5 questions. Total 20 questions will be asked. If you prepare well these 4 topics, you can score minimum 16 to 18 questions. Okay, we'll answer for 16 to 18 questions with 100% marks. Why? Because the thing is that without these questions, these are part of the syllabus, so they cannot skip these topics. Okay, if you have good mathematical skills, if you practice properly, you can answer all 5 data interpretation questions, like a bar chart or pie chart or tabular format. They'll be giving some data, you have to answer this. See, without having, many people will not answer this. They, first of all, they will go for theory questions. Before 15 minutes or 20 minutes, they will try to answer data interpretation, data comprehension. Due to time constraint, you will get pressurized and you will be going for the blind answers. So the end of the day, they are losing their marks. Okay, so that's why people will get a little less score compared to paper 2, even though it is very easy. So if you practice well, you can have some good score in data interpretation and data comprehension. Even data comprehension, see, being a postgraduate student, it's not that difficult to write one or two paragraphs and answer 5 questions. Okay, so even it's a added benefit for people who knows read and write Hindi. Why? Because if your mother tongue is Hindi, it's very, there is Hindi medium also available, so that you can easily go through that paragraph in one less than 2 minutes, so that you can answer the questions properly. So first of all, go through the data interpretation, practice well. Without practice, don't go for this. If you have good practice on data interpretation, go for data interpretation, then data comprehension, then logical reasoning. Even in reasoning also, two questions from direct reasoning, one question for coding and decoding, one question from odd man out, and other one question from general aptitude. All these are basic level only. They will not go for in-depth level. So go for logical reasoning next. The next thing is that computer terminology. See, it's added benefit for computer science students. Why? Because they will be asking very basic questions in computer science. People other than computer science stream, it's a little difficult for them, but it's very easy for us to score 5 out of 5. So nowadays they are giving abbreviations. What is the full form of PDF? What is the full form of USB? Okay, what is the full form of RAM, ROM? So if you remember, those abbreviations, there'll be one question, and based on the versions, they'll be asking one question. Word format, a Word file will stored in which format in MS Office 2007.docx docs file. Okay, if it is 2003, which format? So just like this, based on versions, there will be a question. So as we are computer science students, it's not that difficult for us to remember. So these are all very easy questions for us. So next thing is general knowledge. If you have good idea about Lok Sabha, Raj Sabha, Parliament, and Rashtrapati, Uprashtrapati, as Prime Minister, okay. At least one question will be coming from these topics. Okay. So first of all, instead of going to the complete theory questions, first go through this so that you will get some good score. Anyway, at the end, you will be going to that, these questions will not take more than half an hour. Okay, if you dedicate half an hour for this, remaining half an hour you can go for concentrate on your theory questions like teaching aptitude, research aptitude. Go for teaching aptitude, research aptitude directly. Why? Because at least half of the questions will be testing your common sense. Okay, by using very simple questions, if you practice or don't practice, out of time definitely you will get five questions get corrected. Okay, if you use common sense. So please go through that teaching aptitude, research aptitude. So here, here itself you can score 20 questions here, and if you score 2 or 3 questions here, 23, and 5 questions from 5 or 6 questions from teaching and research aptitude, so around 30. So 60% is a very good score in paper 1. So don't worry, it's very easy to score marks in paper 1. So but you have to have a better plan. Without a plan you cannot execute it properly. So practice data interpretation and comprehension and basic arithmetic questions so that you can have some good score in paper 1. Next one is paper 2. So before going through this, the thing is that first of all I will explain what are the subjects and topics you have to prepare and then go for the exam mode. First of all, we have almost they have given up, according to the updated syllabus, we have to prepare 18 subjects. Okay, we have to prepare 18 subjects. Thing is that people could have completed their MCAs or MTechs or BTechs in 2012 or 13 or 14, still giving this exam. It's very difficult for them to again prepare all those 18 subjects. And people who don't have time, the thing is that if they try to prepare all those 18 subjects, you cannot even complete one single subject. You will get bored or you will get frustrated. So you will left for the preparation. So you will directly go for the examination. You will go for blind marks so that end of the day you will not get qualified. So as you have very less time, don't go for complete 18 subjects or 15 subjects. Choose any 6 subjects where you have good idea. According to me, I am good at below 6 subjects. So I'll be preparing only those subjects, in depth. Okay, why? Because 2 months is not a short time, so that six subjects it's okay, because you can cover. If you sit and prepare for a complete weekend, you can complete at least 75% of a particular subject. Just like that, you can, with the weekends itself, will complete 3 subjects. Remaining 3 subjects weekdays, it's okay, fine. So go for at least 6 subjects less than 1 subject and 2 subject, you can't do anything. Okay, at least 6 subject you should prepare. Okay, the thing is that I am good at data structures and C programming. Even in data structures and C programming, the added advantage is most of the times they will be asking about the applications and the definitions. They will not ask any programs. So don't worry, people who are not good at programming, they don't need to remember the complete program, or else they don't need to write any programs here. See, the thing is that most of the time they will be asking about the applications, or they will be asking about the outputs. If you know the concept, you can answer that question. Okay, you don't need to remember the syntax of C language or Java. You should know about the concept. Okay, then you can answer that question. So data structures and C programming, computer networks, database management systems, software engineering, theory of computation and operating systems. You should be having very good idea about all these subjects. And if you compare last two papers, we should add computer graphics or artificial intelligence. Why? Because every year at least 6 or 8 questions will be asking from both the subjects. 4 questions each. Artificial intelligence and computer graphics. So it will be good if you have any one of them in your preparation list. Okay, next thing is that don't depend on completely on theory. Okay, don't depend completely on theory. Why? Because even though if you prepare plenty of theory, they will be asking indirect questions. Okay, so you should have better understanding of the concept. If you understand it properly, you can answer that question. You can by heart normal forms, complete normal forms, first normal form, second normal form, BCNF, okay, fourth normal form, fifth normal. But in the examination, they would given different indirect question. they will give you a particular functional dependency. They want us to find out whether it's a first normal form, second form, or third normal form. Okay, they will not ask you what is the definition of a first normal form. Okay, they will not ask you what is the mesh topology. Okay, just like that. So you should have some better understanding of the concept. You should think, you should analyze that. Okay, you should have some better understanding of the concept. Without a better understanding, you cannot crack those questions. Okay, solve at least last 10 year papers. It's very important. See, anyway, you are having a very short time. So the thing is that if you prepare for last 10 years papers, at least you will have some good idea how they are asking question, which subject is important, which is not important. Okay, where you can put efforts more, where you should not put your efforts more. So you can verify those things. So, and even some blind questions will be there every time. See, you have not prepared digital logic. There will be some formulas will be there. Okay, for the these are all blind questions. Okay, you can directly go for them. Or else, what is the fastest logic gate? Some definitions. What is the fastest logic gate? Okay. Or else they will be asking what is the time complexity of a binary search tree. Or else what is the for pure alloha it will be 0.184, slotted alloha it will be 0.368. some blind marks. Okay, you should remember this blind. Why? Because you are not preparing, you are not having full-fledged preparation. So definitely you should have some by heart some formulas. Okay, these are blind marks. So at least if you get two or three questions also, it will be very beneficial, right? Because you are getting eight or six marks from those blind questions. So try to remember some formulas, or if you prepare last 10 year paper, you can understand, and you can try to answer some blind questions. Okay, next one. While giving examination, if you don't prepare well, or else if you don't prepare all the subjects, first of all, motivate yourself. Without self-confidence, you cannot do anything. Okay, first of all, motivate yourself. Be confident about the examination. Why? Because headcount doesn't decide the number of candidates, okay, who qualified or not qualified. Don't depend on the headcount, okay, because out of 100, only 6% only they will pick. Out of 100, only 20% of the serious aspirant will be there. Okay, remaining all will be just giving a try. Okay, so don't demotivate yourself. Just try to motivate yourself. Be cool and patient. And first of all, choose the questions from the prepared subjects only. Don't go through the complete subjects. Okay, the first first question is from computer graphics, or else some matrices. You are trying to solve this, or else linear programming question will be there. You are trying to solve that. No, that is not the proper way. First of all, choose the questions from prepared. By looking at the question, you can understand whether it's from it's in one of the six subjects or not. Okay, if you have that, just try to answer that, or else leave it, because you have 2 hours of time, 2.5 hours of time. You can do it later also. Okay, why? Because first try to answer for the known questions. See, the thing is that even in the prepared subjects also, first go through the direct questions. There will be some direct questions will be there, like definitions. There will be some questions like definitions. Okay, they will be giving some IP address. It belongs to which class? Class A, class B, class C, class D, class C. They will give the IP address. So you can directly, it's a direct question. You can solve it. What is the time complexity of binary search tree? Which one of the following is fastest? Okay, these are all direct questions. Like, or else they will ask you about some definitions. Okay, so try to answer those direct questions first of all. Okay, next, in the second phase, try to answer the problems. Okay, try to answer, solve the problems. Next, you're done with the prepared subjects. In the prepared subject, you have answered in two phases. One is direct questions, other one is solving the problems. You are done. Next one is, still there are some questions left from the prepared subjects. So what will you do? The thing is that try for elimination method. Definitely out of four options, at least minimum two options will be unrelated. Okay, so try to eliminate them. I mean, it's very easy for us to identify, I mean, guess a right one from two options compared to four options, right? Try to eliminate those two irrelevant answers. Okay, so using the elimination method, 50% of the questions will be get answered. Next one, you are done with complete things. Next, which are subjects which you have not prepared. So read the question properly and identify the clue. As I told you, if you prepare last 10 years papers, you should have some blind marks, or else you could have remembered some formulas. So using that, you can answer some questions. For that, you need to prepare, I mean, you need to go through the complete question clearly. Okay, properly you have to go through the question and identify that particular clue. Using that, you can solve that. Okay, don't leave or don't go for option. First question I have answered like answer B, now it is answer C, next option answer D, next again answer A. Just don't go for that. Don't go for that stupid way. Okay, because every question, if I mean, I got disqualified for NET two times, short of 4 marks. I mean, two questions only. Okay, in 2014 and 2016. Just because of two questions. So every question is important here. See you cannot predict the future, right? So instead of going for blind answers, just try to read the question properly and answer it. Next one is, as there is no negative marking, try to attempt all. Why? Because there is no negative marking, nothing wrong in attempting all the questions. Okay, if you don't have time, or else if you are, you don't have any way to answer that, go for it. Just answer anything, A, B, C, D, something else. Okay, you have to follow this manner. It's just a trick. Okay, which works for me some time back. So who are all not preparing seriously, or else who are all not having time for preparation. So go through this, it works out for me. Thank you. All the best.